Hey guys, what's up? Check it out. This is my new spiked hair. I am so psyched about it. It's actually really geometric. It's a stellated rhombicuboctahedron minus 5 points so I can stick my head in the middle. It's actually a whole new way of locking points together. I call it Flexi-Star. Flexi-Star. The Flexi-Star system can be used to make a whole range of different stellated polyhedra. No cutting, tape, or glue. And they stay together really well. And I should probably begin by showing you how to fold this one, but Halloween's coming up, so I imagine you guys want to learn how to make this wig. It's rather difficult. It's actually rather easy once you get the hang of it. So if you're up for the challenge, then ready, set, let's go. All right, so for this spiky wig, you need 55 6-inch squares of paper. And I highly recommend that you use different colors. That way you can make 11 groups of five, and then you just stick them together. In fact, I recommend that you make 12 groups of five, so use 60 sheets in all. That way you can make the complete ball, otherwise known as the stellated rhombicuboctahedron. And then all you have to do is you take off one of the groups of five and you'll have a wig, and it'll be a comfortable wig to wear. All right, I'm gonna start out with the orange group of five. So let's begin white side up, and let's fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Now let's unfold and rotate, and let's fold in half again diagonally in this direction. We're going to make a water bomb base. So let's fold this corner to the top and turn over right to left, and let's fold this corner to the top. And now let's open the big pocket, put your finger all the way to the bottom, and let's bring these two points together and squash. And here we have the water bomb base. Okay, now let's rotate and let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this crease. And let's repeat on this side. And let's turn over and repeat on this side. And rotate. And let's fold in half. And we're done with our first module. Just so that it stays flat, I'm going to stick it underneath this bowl. This is a bowl I made in pottery class. So it makes a nice weight. And now I'm going to make four more. Oh, and I want to show you a little trick to make water bomb bases a little bit faster. What you do is you fold it in half diagonally, and then all you have to do is push like this, or rather push down like this, and then align these two edges and these two edges and flatten. And then you just fold this flap up and bring it back down so that we have the crease, and fold the edge to the crease. Alright, so we have our first five modules, and now it's time to connect them. So let's first connect these two. So let's hold them like this. Let's pretend like they're two slugs and they're sliming along, but they're actually super slugs because they have wings and they can fly. So let's lower one wing of each slug, and let's stick one wing inside the other. slide it all the way in like that. And now let's bring the two tails together so that they touch. And then let's separate them. And now we're going to fold this point up to this point. And you can see where that point is because of this flap. So right there. And now let's bring the tails together and flatten. And here we have two slugs that are attached. So we have our duo slug, and let's get a third slug. And now they're slithering along, and let's do the same thing. So let's drop a wing on each and stick the wing inside the other and slide it in and bring the two tails together and separate them. And now let's fold this corner up to this point. And close it up. And here we have a trio of slugs. Let's get a fourth. And do the same thing. And close it up, and we have a quartet. And now let's get the fifth slug and do the same thing. And close it up. Okay, so here we have our five slugs, and let's spread out their tails so that it makes a slug star. And now let's drop these two wings and stick one inside the other, slide it all the way in, and let's bring these two tails together, and let's pinch right there. And now let's bring all five tails up. But when you do that, make sure to keep your thumb right here. And bring all the tails up so that they touch. And now flatten it and open this flap. And now let's fold this flap up, just like before. And fold the flap back up so that we have all five points together and it is symmetrical. And our first quintet of slugs is complete. And now we just need to make 11 more. All right, so I folded all 12 modules and now it's time to assemble them. So let's start with these six. So I'm gonna use the yellow one as the middle. This is gonna be the top of the wig. And then these five will go around it. So let's start out by bringing the yellow one up to this purple one. And we're going to attach it. It doesn't really matter where we start. Just attach two flaps by sticking one inside the other, like this. And like we've been doing it, we're going to lock it by folding the flap over. And let's bring the newly locked flaps together, like that. Okay, now let's take this neighboring flap right here, and take this neighboring flap, and we're going to attach these two flaps to the blue one. So take any point, and let's bring it up so that the two can come together. Slide it in, and let's lock it, let's take the neighboring blue flap and the neighboring purple flap, and let's bring them together. Okay, and let's lock it. And let's bring all three of the newly locked flaps together. So this is a trio. We have the yellow quintet here, purple quintet, and blue quintet, and here we have the trio. Now, as part of this trio, we need to make three quartets. So the first quartet is these four flaps. So let's come down from the trio and attach the two nearest flaps. That would be these two. And let's lock them. So there is the quartet, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, here's our trio. Let's go find another quartet. So right here, and find the nearest two flaps, which are these. And let's lock them together. Now, if you find that it's hard to get them together and all these flaps are in the way, if you bring these flaps together and bring these flaps together, then that kind of gets the flaps out of the way and lets you lock it. Okay, and there's the quartet. Okay, here we have a trio. Let's rotate and find the other quartet, which is right here. So let's take the nearest flaps and let's lock them. Try to get these flaps out of the way. So here we have the trio, and here we have the first group of four, and the second group of four, and the third group of four. Okay, so we have successfully attached the purple and the blue to our central home base yellow. So let's now attach the red. So we're going to make a trio with the purple and the yellow. So let's attach any point of the red to the yellow. And let's lock it. And now let's complete the trio by locking the nearest two flaps. And bring the three flaps together. You might have to spread them apart a little bit just so that they're more flexible. And here we have the trio. Now we have to make the groups of four. So this one's already done because we already attached it. So the first one's done. The second quartet is right here. So let's take the nearest flaps and put it together and lock it. All right, so here's our trio, and we have the first quartet
and the second quartet done. We just need to make this quartet right here. So let's bring the nearest flaps together. Okay, so the red one is successfully attached. So we have the blue, purple, red, and now let's do, doesn't really matter, but I'm gonna go for the green so that we have more contrast. So let's attach a new flap from the green to the yellow. Oh, not that flap because it won't attach. Let's complete the trio by bringing these two flaps together. And let's lock them. Okay, so here we have our trio. We've done the first quartet. We need to do this quartet right here. So bring the nearest flaps together and lock them. Okay, so we have this quartet and this quartet. We need to do this quartet. Okay, so here we have the blue, purple, red, and green attached. Let's attach the last one, the orange. And let's attach it to the yellow. I'm going to slide it out a little bit so that it's more flexible. And we're going to make a trio with the green. So let's attach these two flaps. Okay, and this is getting a little bit difficult, so I'm going to wrap these corners together and some of these corners just to get them out of the way. And lock it. Okay, so we have this trio, and this quartet is done, and let's do this quartet right here. And here's our trio, let's do this quartet. Okay, so we've done all three quartets, but now we need to attach the orange and the blue together. So let's make a trio with the orange and the blue and the yellow. All right, so there's the trio and two quartets are done. Let's just do this last quartet. Okay, so here we have the top semisphere of our ball. So we have the yellow and the five other colors going around. Now let's continue by adding five down here. And since the orange is over here, I'm going to put this orange on the opposite end. So it's going to be attached to the red and purple. So here's where the red and purple come together. And let's take the nearest flap and take any flap of the orange and stick it into the red, and let's lock it. Okay, so we're going to make a trio with the red, orange, and purple. So let's get the nearest two flaps and lock them. All right, so here we have the trio. Let's get the quartets. So we need to do the red and orange quartet. And we need to do the orange and purple quartet. So we've attached the orange. Now let's attach the green. So here's the top of the sphere, here's the green, and let's go to the opposite side. So we're going to attach the green to the purple and orange. So let's make a trio with the purple, orange, and green. And bring the trio together. So here's the trio, let's get the quartets. We've already done the orange and purple. Let's do the orange and green. Okay, and let's do the purple and green. Okay, now let's attach the green and the blue. So we're going to make a trio with the green, blue, and purple. And let's get the quartet. Like that. Alright, so let's see where we are. We have the yellow on top, and on the bottom we've already attached the orange and the green, and coming around we're going to attach one more here. On the opposite side is the red, so let's attach the red to the green and the blue. So, here we go. Okay, so here we have the trio, and we need to make the quartets. Let's do the red and the green quartet. And let's do the blue and the red quartet. Okay, so now let's make a trio with the blue, orange, and red. And let's make the quartet. Okay, so we have all the quartets made. So once again, we have yellow on top, and we've attached on the bottom the orange, green, and red. And here we have the purple. Let's attach the purple to the orange and red. Okay, and now let's make a trio out of the green, purple, and orange. Alright, so here, once again, we have the yellow on top, and we only have two more. We know that the yellow is going to be on the bottom, so let's attach the blue to the purple, green, red, and orange. Better. Okay, so I think that they're all attached. We just need to attach the bottom. So if you just want a wig, you could wear it like that. Another thing you could do is you can bisect all of these points so you can have extra points that come out like this. But if you do that, I found that wearing it all day, these raw edges are a little bit uncomfortable. So I recommend just tucking these flaps inside the hat and you can wear it like that. All right, but since some of you might want to have a ball instead of a wig, I'm going to attach the last piece. So, just attach any two corners. And let's complete the red and yellow quartet. And I believe this is the very last lock. And there is the ball. Now, if you'll notice, all of the trios are kind of separated, whereas the groups of 5 points are kind of together. So what we need to do is push the trios all together to try to even out the points. And I'm going to just do that by undoing this trio right here. That way, I can get my hand inside. And now, I'm going to go around pinching all the trios. So bring a trio together, and I don't know if you can see it, but I'm pinching all three of the edges. One, two, and three. So that makes this trio want to hang together better. Okay, so let's try to do this systematically. So I'm going to go around the purple. So we just did this trio. Now let's do this trio. Okay, forget systematically. Let's just go around and close any trios that you see that are open. And if you see that some don't want to close very easily, you can try to pull them apart a little bit. That'll make them bend easier. Okay, I'm going to pull my hand out and try to push the trios together from the outside. Okay, I'm going to close this back up. Okay, that's looking a little bit better. You can also try spreading out the groups of five. And there it is. All right, well that was an epic tutorial. All right, so if you want to make it back into a wig, you can just pull out the yellow or whichever one you want. And there it is. And now these flaps can just go inside and they'll be a little bit softer than the raw edges. You see how this flap is soft, whereas this is hard, at least from my experience. And now you can just shape them to taste. And from in here, you really can bring the trios very easily together. And there you have it. All right, so there it is, all done. And now let's see how it fits. Pretty good. Now, time to juggle. Whoa. Stellated rhombicosidodecahedron. Yeah!